Welcome to another edition of the Davidson Football Coach's Corner with Scott Abell, powered by Wade Associates. Coach, the Wildcats gutted out a home Pioneer Football League win, clinching consecutive winning seasons for the first time since 06-07. What was your message to the team after the win on what they're accomplishing big picture?
Well, you know, it's a great Saturday for us, you know, and, you know, after the game, you know, I remind them of that very stat, you know, and, you know, we talked all offseason that it was time to establish a program. You know, last year was about establishing the culture, and this year, and how do you do that? You know, you establish a program by, you know, putting back-to-back years together, putting consecutive winning seasons together by showing up each and every Saturday. And our guys have done that, and it doesn't always show on the scoreboard. You know, we've lost quite a few tough games since I've been here. You know, a lot of one touchdown losses or wins in the past 2 years. And so this Saturday for us to finish that game the way we did, to drive the field, to get the win, to get a big defensive stop there, really proud of our guys, incredibly proud of our effort. And excited that we're moving in the direction that we all hoped we would be.
Davidson 6-3 entering the final stretch of the season. You have three losses, but three wins out of those losses. What does that tell you about your guys and how the program has grown?
Well, see, you know, that it's grown tremendously. And you talk about year two. You know, what are the things you want to see in year two? Well, you know, we talk about it's hard to, you know, very few programs line up each and every week and say, okay, we're going to go undefeated, or, you know, we can play our subpar game and still win the football game. Well, we know we're not that program. And so we have to show up each and every Saturday. And you if you stumble, that's going to happen, right? You want to pick yourself up and you want to play better the next week and learn from it. And we seem to have done that, you know. Last year we kind of, you know, had a couple tough losses there in a row, right? And so you hope that you learn from that and you grow. And I think the evidence is right here in this year when we've had a tough loss here and there and we've rebounded and got some big wins.
Another strong defensive effort from your guys. You had two interceptions. You got pressure on Chris Duncan all day, forcing him to make rushed and poor decisions. Who stood out on the defensive side of the ball this week?
Well, once again, I think we're just playing incredibly great team defense. You know, you have a lot of guys, you know, doing their part and doing their role. And that's really how we're built defensively. You know, but, you know, when you look at Harrison Hill had a great game. You know, George had a great game. You know, those are two that really jump off at me. You know, Harrison was in the backfield all day. You know, I don't know if he actually got a sack credited to him, but he was forcing early throws, getting pressure on him. And George led us in tackles, who seemed to be everywhere Saturday, had a big interception at the end. You know, and I want to give a shout-out to our special teams, right? I mean, man, they played well Saturday, forced a turnover, really forced two turnovers. We weren't the beneficiary of the second one, unfortunately, but what a great Saturday they had as well.
Wesley Duggar added to his ever-growing touchdown total. You got Jarrell Story back in the end zone a couple times. You were able to dominate time of possession. How well was the offensive game plan executed on Saturday?
Well, really well, you know, with the exception of, you know, the turnovers, right? You know, you know, we came in saying we want to control the clock, and you know, we know we're really banged up on that side of the football. But we know when we execute and we don't hurt ourselves, we can be a dominant offense, and that can look a lot of different ways. Sometimes it looks in 10 to 12 play drives, and that's when we've been at our best this year. And so we talked about that, and I know everybody, including our own guys, want to see these great big plays and score quickly, but that's just not realistic all the time. And so, helping our guys understand that has been one of the things we've talked about a lot these last 3 or 4 weeks. And to see us come out and execute the way we did, you know, and the turnovers, one, Tyler took a shot, you know, on his, you know, I'll call that one a forced turnover. And the second one, you know, Eli just does so much for us. And you know, we got to find maybe ways to get him breaks because, you know, he's tired at times. You know, the way we drove the field, we hit big pass plays when we needed it, right? We got really both our big backs involved with Wes and Story, and that was a key going into the game. How could we utilize them together at times? And that's really the first time we've done that. And that's exciting for our program as we head down the home stretch.
You're going on the road for the final two trips of the year, this Saturday starting at Butler. What's your initial scouting report of the 2-7 Bulldogs?
Well, you know, they remind me of a lot of our league, right? You know, they're a team that each and every Saturday has had a chance to win a lot of football games and has just fallen a little bit short, you know, but they're no different from any of us, right? You know, San Diego seems to be the mark, right? And the rest of us are very similar, right? We're good solid football programs that if you don't show up each and every Saturday, right, you're going to find yourself disappointed at the end of the game. And so they're a good team, good program, and they've had some hard luck this year, you know, but I know they'll be ready to be at their best at home, and we need to be ready to match that.
All right, well, that will do it for this edition of the Football Coaches Corner with Scott Abell, powered by Wade Associates. Davidson travels to Butler this weekend for a PFL showdown, kickoff at noon. Follow along at DavidsonWildcats.com and on Davidson FB. For Scott Abell, I'm Jake Brewer. We'll see you next Monday.